As you go forward and read more advanced algorithms, it's likely you'll encounter different notation for the same objects. Sometimes this is due to different authors' preferences, but other times it's because one author changes notation in different contexts to emphasize distinct aspects of a problem. Today, we'll consolidate the notation and explain all the possible choices so you have one reference to come back to if you get lost. I should preface this by saying that we'll be talking only about basis cats, not general cats. We're going to describe, in some cases, review different ways to express the few CBS cats in HN, not the infinity of vectors in that space. With that qualification, we begin with the familiar representation of CBS cats in HN. We've met different ways to express them. That notation remains in force. It's the most common. These CBS cats can be aligned with a totally different vector space, the finite vector space of n-tuples whose values are either 0 or 1, and that's our second environment. Now, this is not a Hilbert space, just an oddball vector space. The most notable weirdness of it is that its vectors are added using mod 2 addition applied component-wise. We designate this space by z sub 2 all raised to the n. The third and final environment we want to associate with the CBS cats of HN is one we've actually seen. We've been calling it the encoded form of the CBS tensors. So instead of writing ket 11010, we might write ket 26, which is the decimal form of 11010. This environment is called z subscript 2 to the n. You have to watch those parentheses to distinguish it from the vector space z sub 2 all to the n. The only thing new here is a note about the addition operation, which is not integer addition. There will be times when we want to add these encoded numbers inside the kets. It'll usually appear at the output of the quantum oracle's B register. So we formally introduce the group of integers z sub 2 to the n with this strange addition. It's the same addition as in the vector space I just described, mod 2, applied to each of the numbers' binary digits. Somehow it seems more palatable when we apply it to two vectors than when we're using it on two encoded decimal integers, which is why I want you to be aware of this third environment. A likely mistake would be to add 2 plus 3 inside the ket and get the incorrect answer 5 rather than the correct answer 1. A consequence of these different notational systems is that the nth order Hadamard operator can look like this on one day and like this on another and like this on a third.